Back to harness racing here on New England Broadcasting YouTube channel. We have switched locations. We have packed our bags and we headed east. We are at the Grange County 4-H Spring Rounds for 18 weeks of racing tonight, and Anthony will have the call of the races as soon as he's ready upstairs. We'll turn it over to Anthony. And now, I'm going to tell you guys, I'm plugged right directly into the PA system tonight. There's no wireless. I'm plugged right directly into him. So, we're going to have to do a few adjustments. But, you ready? Oh, you gotta change that. I gotta change speakers now. Okay. Well, I thought they were ready, but they gotta change speakers around. So we'll see if they get things changed upstairs. Getting the track watered down. And then we'll get rocking. We're still playing with it up there. Trying to get things all set so we can hear Anthony up there. So that's our Grange County 4-H Spring Rounds for 18 races tonight. But the good thing I got the wireless stuff. We may need it. There's a possibility. Huh? So I take one of these of this and chips you want to add. I think I mentioned it because Anthony runs that. So if I don't mention it, Anthony will be all over me if I don't. So check it to all your fees. You got one of these of this and chips you want to. I think we're still waiting for waiting for everything upstairs. Getting the track watered down. Huh? We're still working on. Yeah. Trying to get everything all situated upstairs. So looking for some more. Well. Not sure what they're looking. They're looking for us. Okay, until they figure out what's going on upstairs, we'll take some TOs. A couple of folks, you get down in Florida, hang loose. We will be hopefully back in a little bit for 18 heats of harness races.
Looking for some very good food? Then visit 41 Degrees North in downtown Millbury. The staff at 41 Degrees North will treat you with first class. Looking at a great steak? Even a hamburger? How about some french fries with that hamburger? Then 41 Degrees North is the place in downtown Millbury across from First State Bank.
Sean was about to strike out and end the season. Or so they thought. He'd been doing the one thing proven to make a big difference in any player's game. Practice. In the same year-round place where pros recruited by the Chicago Cubs train. There's never been anything like it in the history of this region. And it'll change your game, too. First Source Bank Performance Center. Wow the crowd by stopping those hard slams and short hops other infielders fear. Put the ball where you want it and get on base when it matters most. Pitch faster and better than anyone else. Train with regulation baseballs, softballs, and the professional players you need to up your game the way the pros do now. In the off-season at First Source Bank Performance Center. Memberships, individual lessons, infield, pitching, batting, softball, and baseball all year long. Visit FirstSourceBankPerformanceCenter.com today. FirstSourceBankPerformanceCenter.com.
Paul was born in Massachusetts, but it was raised in Indiana. The Indiana Basketball Hall of Fame shows you why high school basketball is a hysteria in Indiana. Many sights and sounds are to be seen and heard here. Hear the crowd roar as you hit the winning shot. Watch the history of Indiana basketball in the Marsh Theater. See greats like Larry Bird, John Wooden, and Oscar Robertson. Search the library for endless stories. It's all here at the Indiana Basketball Hall of Fame, located 40 minutes east of Indianapolis and Newcastle. Visit them online at hoopshall.com for more information.
Bunch of Pros served Michigan for over 30 years with quality pools, spas, and service. But what they have to offer is pools, spas, all their accessories are up for complete installation, service, and maintenance. Bonshore Pools has two locations to serve you in South Bend and Elkhart. Call Bonshore Pools at 1-800-875-6550 or visit their Elkhart store at 23695 US 33 East in Elkhart.
Have a dirty vehicle, need a clean vehicle? Then rent your vehicle through Caribbean Auto Spa. Caribbean Auto Spa has two locations to serve you, 2714 Emerson Drive in Elkhart and 503 Heritage Drive in Millbury. Check out the Housing Co. location also at 2623 South Avenue Street in Elkhart. Check out their website at cewashes.com for specials.
This is Dave Ramsey here to talk about Rain Drain. Rain Drain is your local dealer for the amazing Leaf Guard no-clog gutter system. Leaf Guard is the only seamless one-piece leaf protection system on the market today. It's a patented system that's built to stay clog-free, guaranteed. Or Rain Drain will clean your gutters for free. To learn more, call Rain Drain at 888-611-RAIN or visit them at raindraininc.com.
Check out the many specials for Porcetown Lane Store this week. Some of the specials are boneless, skinless chicken breast for $1.29, ham steaks for $1.19, evaporated milk, 12 ounce, 4 for $1, mushroom sleeves and pieces, 4 ounce, 2 for $1, crispy rice cereal, 12 ounce, for 79 cents, bottled water cases, 24 for $2.29. Windproof charcoal lighter, 99 cents. Family pack ice cream, 4-quart pails, $4.49, and many more. Check them out at Porcetown Lane Store in Millbury.
Looking to support your school? Looking for a local hometown bank? Then First State Bank is the bank for you. Get that spirit card to support your school. Get out there to the area stores and use that spirit card for all your needs. First State Bank has locations in Millbury, Goshen, Elkhart, Mishawaka, and South Bend. First State Bank, members FDIC.
Our water is right on everything. Your pipes, appliances, clothes, and you. A Puritan water softener from Hawkins Water Tech eliminates minerals that dry your skin while saving you money on repairs, soap, shampoos, and laundry detergent. Hawkins Water Tech. We work hard to bring you soft water. SNL's Heritage Hall offers musical concerts, dramatic theatrical performances, comedians, and a wide variety of live entertainment. Visit SNLs.com to view the schedule of events or purchase tickets. We look forward to your visit to our campus.
Life is full of changes and challenges. The right life insurance coverage can help you plan ahead for whatever may happen, both expected and unexpected. Call or visit your local Beacon Insurance Agency, Mass Insurance, in Goshen about the wide range of life insurance products that can be your life preserver for whatever stage of life you are in. Universal life, term life, preferred whole life, single pay child life, annuities, and more will go beyond the expected for you and your loved ones. Call Mass Insurance, your Pekin Insurance Agency, at 574-534-6278 today about life insurance.
Alright, nestled in the heart of Amish country and Quake community of Millbrae, there's an unassuming hidden gem located near South Bend and only minutes from Shipshawana, Meadow Valley Golf Course, and a prime destination. Meadow Valley Golf Club is the past host of the Indiana PGA events that include the Indiana PGA Northern Open, the Indiana PGA Pro Junior, the Indiana PGA Father-Son Championships. The evidence that is the area's premier golf course speaks for itself. Meadow Valley is located at 576-00-013 in Millbrae. Their phone number is 574-825-3422. That's MeadowValleyGC.com on the web. Looking for a fun night? Are you a race fan? Then New Pride Speedway is the place to go. They offer a family fun night of stock car racing. Great food. Visit the game shop. For more information, visit NewPrideSpeedway.com. That's www.newprideSpeedway.com for the complete schedule. Looking for a hometown butcher that will treat your meat first class. Looking for meats for your tailgate party. And Old Hoosier Meat is the place for you. Old Hoosier Meat has smoked meats, cheese, and a lot more. Old Hoosier Meat is located at 101 Wayne Street, New Millbrae. Call the Painless Butcher at 574-825-2940.
I'm so tired of cleaning those gutters every year. I'm getting too old for this.
Why don't you call Rain Drain? They have the leaf guard system that's guaranteed to never clog.
But we need a new roof first.
They do those too. They even have the stone-coated steel roofing, which is the best roof money can buy.
Rain Drain, huh? Let me give them a call.
With over 18 years' experience, Rain Drain offers gutters, roofing, windows, and siding for your free estimate. Call 888-611-RAIN or visit their website for more information at raindraininc.com.
Are you in need of a high-quality used car? Then look no further than Richie Auto Sales in Millbrae. For over 28 years, Richie Auto Sales only high-quality automotives. They have many specials to choose from and a friendly staff to help you find what you're looking for. Check out their website at RichieAutoSales.com and see what deals they have for you. Open Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 5:30, and Saturday from 8 to 1 or by appointment. Stop by and see the fine folks at Richie Auto Sales, 801 South Main Street in Millbrae.
This is Dave Ramsey here to talk about Rain Drain. Rain Drain is your local dealer for the amazing Leaf Guard no-clog gutter system. Leaf Guard is the only seamless one-piece leaf protection system on the market today. It's a patented system that's built to stay clog-free, guaranteed. Or Rain Drain will clean your gutters for free. To learn more, call Rain Drain at 888-611-RAIN or visit them at raindraininc.com.
right. Here's the deal. They have got speaker problems. We're going to go off the air for a little while. We may have to plug their speaker system into this thing. It's a possibility. And if that's the case, I need to shut things up for a little while and get things redone. So we'll be back on. Give me about at least a half hour, 45 minutes. It's going to be at least that long. So we're gonna sign off, but everybody will get the notification when we come back. So just hang loose by the computer, folks. We will be back. When? I have no idea when. But we will, unless the, well, wait a minute. Hey, I just heard something. And take that back upstairs. It's on your shoulder.
Yeah, it was on my head.
Well, the connection they need is on your shoulder.
Yeah, well, what do you want me to do about it?
Take it upstairs.
What the hell with that noise? I go up those steps 3-4 times to go up the time, to come down, to go back up a time. I struggle with going upstairs.
Okay, tell me, I got to get upstairs. Hang on a minute, folks. Can you get that handled? Hang on.
Okay, wait a minute.
Hang on. Well, come on.
Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated. Once again, we apologize for the technical difficulties, but we'll get through it here. We've got 18 heats of action pack racing in store for you this evening. Drivers, once again, let's bring them out here for race number one. Okay, guys. Remember,
hey,
the thing comes up quick and they're tight. So give each other a little.
You want the wireless or you want to play direct? Okay, all right. Just plug it into the front there. Okay, this trip. Thank you, sir.
Yep.
Okay. Unplug it. Let's go with the wireless. Unplug it. I've been to wireless
up to. Ladies and gentlemen, the upcoming race number one, we have a driver change of the 3-year-old Solo Cup to Luke Miller. Luke Miller, driver's permit, please.
That turns it on and off for you right there. You get to think about it. And I'll control things downstairs. There you are. Thanks, Anthony. Can't disappoint my Florida people.
Driver's Lodge, race number one.
Anthony's got the wires
are on the track here for tonight's first race. A field of six. These are 106 and faster. Free for all pacers. Driver change on the 3 red Solo Cup to Luke Miller. Here's the 1, the Blue Meadow Lucy. Owner driver Rose Bontrager. 2, Hilltop Sand Shooter, owned by Rose Bontrager with Kevin Slaybaugh. 3, Red Solo Cup, owned by Bruce Wyman of Three Rivers, Michigan. Luke Miller's your driver. Luke Miller on the 3. 4 is Miss Bay, owned by the Rocky Ridge Stables with Ryan Yoder. 5, Nitro, owned by the Rocky Ridge Stables, Jason Yoder Drives. And the 6, Lou Adios, owned by the Hilltop Pacing Acres. Seth Miller is in the sulky. Field of 6, we're going to start off with a bang here. Free for all pacers, they'll be at the gate momentarily.
All right, Anthony's got the wireless. So we said we're going high tech tonight. If you want, I pull my picture, get my best side.
Thank you. I'll tell you, I just
noticed. Yeah, I'm yeah, that's what scares me.
One of those, you know? Yes,
yeah.
Okay.
All right. I think we're at the gate. Yeah, up the gate's moving. It's in the back stretch. So I got my first response. Hi, Mike, what's wrong with the sound system up there? Well, Nathan, it's a good question, Nathan.
Gators rolling. Four on the gate, two trailers. The Devon Miller starting gate has entered the stretch. It's post time. Here they come. And they're off and pacing a good start here. Blue Meadow Lucy, Hilltop Send Shooter to the outside. Red Solo Cup, three deep into the first turn. To the inside, Nitro is there. Ben Relegated to the pocket seat in fourth. Lou Audio second over fifth. And the trailer Miss Bay as they speed to the far turn and sweeping to the lead. There is Red Solo Cup, or Hilltop Send Shooter rather. Hilltop Send Shooter on the front by a length. To the outside, parked now. First up, Red Solo Cup to the inside, Blue Meadow Lucy to the quarter mile marker, 33 seconds, blocked to the inside, Nitro is waiting for daylight, fourth, stalled now to the outside is Lou Adios in fifth as they speed down the backstretch for the second and final time, Hilltop Send Shooter, game on the lead by two, to the inside, Blue Meadow Lucy, and stalled to the outside, Red Solo Cup third, with less than a 16th to go, Hilltop Send Shooter by three. 3.5 Hilltop Send Shooter, much the best here in the first. Blue Meadow Lucy looks to hold on for second with Red Solo Cup.
All right, there you have heat one. Got a little late start, both of it. We're rolling. And Anthony, part of the problem was with me. I thought I could plug in direct and that caused some problems.
Well, I mean, you got it, but I...
So, but right now, Anthony's got, Anthony's got the wireless there, Nathan, so,
4, 6. 2, 1, 3, 5, 4, 6.
We'll get the countdown here in a little bit.
Heading trackside, winning tonight's first race. Free-for-all pacers. The two Hilltop Sand Shooter, four-year-old son of Underestimated out of the Mare Satin Sensation. Owned and trained by Rose Bontrager. Driven to the victory tonight by Kevin Slaybaugh. Third win here on the four-year-old campaign as he takes a mark of 106 here tonight. 106 for the win. Man, that's a tough trip right there.
All right.
Here's your placings for race number one, Blue Meadow Lucy 2, Hilltop Send Shooter the winner. Red Solo Cup 3, Miss Bay 5, Nitro 4, Lou Adios 6. From the top down, 2, 1, 3, 5, 4, 6. Fractional times for the first, the quarter was paced in 33 seconds, 33. Time of the win, 106. Time of the second place horse, 106 and 4. Time of the third horse, also 106, 4 fifths.
All right, folks. There's heat one.
Upcoming race number two, race two, Distaff Trotters. We're looking for a field of five. There are no changes in tonight's second. Drivers, you're all out.
All right. Mary Beth, if you're out there, I still have your stuff. I'm working on it. So just give me time. It's been a hectic last 2 weeks. But I want to thank Mary. Okay, here we go.
the only thing clear on this thing. Here come the horses for race number 2. These are 112 and faster free-for-all trotters. There are no changes. Purse $180. The one is S.H. Lavita, owned by the Sparks Racing Stable with Virgil Slayball. Virgil Slayball, the one. 2 Pistol Packin' Mama, owned by Dennis Shirk of LaGrange, Luke Miller Drives. 3 8 Days in a Week, owned by the MR Stables of Goshen with Derek Lee. 4 Cruise and Chevy, owned by the Indian Creek Stables of Middlebury with Bill Beachy. And the 5 Fancy Move, owned by Rick Hostetler of LaGrange, Larry Weaver is in the sulky. Field of 5 Fast Trotters will be at the gate in 1 minute.
I gotta put Anthony right in the same category as Nathan. It's a compliment. You and Anthony are 1A and 1B. I don't care who's 1A and who's 1B. But then they got the guy down at the Hoosier Park. And folks, we know the guy down at Hoosier Park is good. Right?
Sure.
Well, I never heard him call race, have you?
No, I haven't.
Oh, trust me. He's good. He is good. All right, they should be at the gate. Yep, the gate's in the back stretch. And the gate's moving.
Starter calls. Oh my God, are you kidding me? Again? Test.
Uh-oh.
We got nothing.
Well, they're off, but Anthony doesn't have a microphone. So, not much we can do about this one.
I feel like it did that before, and it's because we didn't have...
So, see if I can pick up who's leading here after. Pick the pack of mama's leading. Right now. And... Well, I hear a click. We may have to get Anthony out. Alright, see, Pizza Pack and Mama's gonna win this. Yep, it's a pack of mama wallet.
1, 3, 4.
All right. So we're going to have to do the best we can because the sound system is not working right tonight. They're still upstairs working on it. And it looks like Pistol Pack and Mama is going to come over. So folks, you get to hear me call some races. Pistol Pack and Mama's gonna. So sorry, Grandma, but Derek didn't win that one. We got Pistol Pack and Mama coming to the winner's circle. We're not sure the times, so we couldn't hear it. All right. Hey, Pistol Pack. Oh, no.
Delbert
with Pistols Aquamama. And I did a shirt of LaGrange train prison to the fruits about by Luke Nero.
All right. All right, Pistol Pack and Mama. You get the picture taken with Pistol Pack and Mama. They got it. And hopefully Anthony will have the countdown if that speaker's still working. Yeah, I should have the headset on here, mine.
So we're going to time it later.
There we go. There we go. Okay. That's got to, he's got back on.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we had a malfunction with the timer here, so we're going to time that at the first intermission. We'll give you official results here for the times for race two after the first break.
All right. So it sounds like we're going to have problems all night.
Here come the horses for race number three. Race three, a division of qualifying pacers, field of four. These are qualifying pacers. No changes in the third. The one is Golden Image, owned by the Sundown Stables with Lauren Bontrager. Two, Love to Run, owned by Gabriel Yoder, J.R. Stutzman Drives. Three, Shady Gold, owner-driver Chris Eicher Jr. Four, Big Kickin' Machine, owned by Willis Slaybaugh, and Pedigree Point Racing with Willis Slaybaugh. Field of four, heading to the gate.
Okay, got field of four here for race three.
Jeez,
man. Now remember, I want my good side. No, God. Tomorrow night, maybe. Tonight, no. I gotta go get chicken tomorrow.
Chicken?
Yeah.
Are you bringing me chicken? We tried to stop at McDonald's on the way here because I'm trying to lose weight, so grilled chicken sandwich. McDonald's no longer sells grilled chicken.
Why not?
I don't know. I asked him. I go, so are no salads, no nothing. I said, so nothing for people trying to lose weight? Because I guess not. Okay, then. So we left and went to Subway.
I don't blame you. All right. Oh, is that the gate? Where's the gate?
Horses have reached the gate.
Yeah, okay.
Gate is rolling. Here they come.
Go.
And the raw off in pacing, off stride at the start, Love to Run. Golden Image has the lead now by two. Big Kickin' Machine to the inside, forwardly placed in second. Shady Gold to the inside is third, and the trailer, Love to Run. Pacers are strung out here, single file, as they step to the backstretch to the upper turn. Golden Image on the engine by two. To the inside, Big Kickin' Machine follows along there in second. Shady Gold back there a wee bit in third, and the trailer is Love to Run. As they step past the stands to the quarter mile marker, Von Trigger has Golden Image on the front, opening quarter 40 seconds. To the inside, Big Kickin' Machine stalking the leader now, waiting patiently to make a move there in a second. Back to the inside, Shady Gold follows in third. Love to Run is the trailer. The pace quickens here as Golden Image is on the front, kicks away by 2.5. To the inside now, earplugs out on Big Kickin' Machine as he's at the leader's wheel. With less than a 16th to go, Golden Image to the outside, Big Kickin' Machine with a rush. Golden Image laboring on the lead, Big Kickin' Machine to the outside. These two are together at the wire. It's too close to call.
Oh, come on, Anthony, call it. Okay, maybe not. Okay. Where am I at? Okay, I know I have it here someplace. Okay, I can't find what I'm looking for. Okay, here we go. Harness Racing Coverage and New World Media is brought to you by Wannabe Service and Chip Shawana, Jayco, New Pair Speedway, Rev, Range Rain, Subway, Troy Carpets, Coppins Commons, and Earl Grossman Funeral Home. And Alan is here tonight. He's got a couple of horses that he's racing. So, by the way, check out One Piece of Us on Facebook. They got a lot of award winners at a couple of area fairs, the Steuben County Fair and here at the LaGrange County Fair, even though it was a little different, but... and also we want to give big thanks out to Snyder Promotions for the banners and for the polo shirts. The product distributor and proud member of the Advertising Social Institute promotional products is a $17 million industry in America. Why? Because trust me, Dave Snyder is good. That's why. So call Dave at 574-536-6588 or check.
Here are your placings for race number 3, Golden Image, your winner. Love to Run 4, Shady Gold 3, Big Kickin' Machine 2. From the top down, 1-4-3-2. Fractional times here. The quarter was paced in 40 seconds. Time of the first and the second horses, 1:16. Time of the third horse, 1:26. Time of the fourth horse was 1:30 flat. In the upcoming race four, looking for a field of 6. These are junior pacers. Driver change on the 6, GV Cheyenne to Michelle Miller.
If you're going to kick it a little harder.
That's not Cheyenne. What is that? Shanae? Anybody?
All right. Here we go.
What is that? How do you pronounce that? Shanae?
I have that.
Shanae? Yeah. Cheyenne.
Okay. Cheyenne.
Wait a minute. We need 6, right? Waiting on 1 drivers. Take a short turn.
Oh, I got a rookie driver out there.
Okay, you're all out, drivers. Bring it this way. Pacers are on the track here for tonight's fourth race. These are junior pacers, 1:12 and 1 to 1:14 pacers. Driver change on the 6, GV Cheyenne to Michelle Miller. Michelle Miller on the 6. Here's the 1, Mystic Gold, owned by the Triple C Racing Stables and Elite Nutrition with Jeremy Chubb. 2, Almost Illegal, owned by Triple C Racing, Dale Miller Drives. 3, Pokey's High Flyer, owned by Jeremy Delagrange. Jeremy Delagrange has the lines. four. What is that? My sass is red? Four is...
Yeah, that's what it is. My sass is red.
Yeah, we might as well. No mic again.
I did get fuses for the other one.
Oh, I'm wrong.
Okay. I will check it during the break and see if I can get that working.
Oh, we got another. Kind of problem with the PA system? Another problem with the PA system? Oh, brother. Whoa! Okay, if they got another problem with the PA system, we're going to do this. Well, where is it? Don't forget, folks, the Summer Sizzler is right around the corner, not in your parish, August 6th. Mark your calendars, 50-lap modified race and a 100-lap outlaw late model race. You order your tickets online. Go to the Imperial Speedway Facebook page to find information how to order. And they got a special races tonight down in New Paris, and they got the Survivor Night of Destruction tomorrow night. Got more equipment problems. Well, folks, you may get to hear me call another race. I may get to call another race. Let's we'll find out here in a little bit. We'll find, yeah, so hang on a minute, folks. We're gonna get this. And by the way, the pretty good crowd here tonight too. It's nice. They're nice spread out. So. Not sure what's going on. Are they going? Well? I think the PA's working. I thought I heard it. Did I hear it? Was I hearing things?
What?
The PA.
What about it?
I thought I heard it.
He said take him to the gate.
Oh, that's what I thought he said. Okay. Yeah, well, that's good.
Yeah.
Too big. Let's get through these two more races and get everything fixed at break.
Well, horse goes down, harness is broken, Other than that, things are good.
Horses have reached the gate. Gate is rolling.
All right, gate's rolling.
Four and two, here they come. And they're off in pacing, almost illegal, gets the call to the inside, Mystic Gold, part to the outside, there in a second. There is Pokey's High Flyer to the inside. GV Cheyenne is blocked there in third, too wide, drafting with that outer flow. My Sass's Red is fourth as they reach the far turn. Your early trailer, Adelaide, as they speed around the far turn and past the stands to the quarter-mile marker, almost illegal on the front, but with heavy pressure to the outside. Pokey's High Flyer challenging for the lead as they reach the quarter-mile marker in 38 seconds, opening quarter, Mystic Gold blocked to the inside, to the outside, Steppy there in a second, fourth, My Sass is Red, and off stride, GV Cheyenne to the inside, and to her outside, three wide comes Adelaide as they speed to the far turn, almost illegal, Pokey's High Flyer still there, kicks it into gear as they cut to the top of the stretch, Pokey's High Flyer to the outside, Mystic Gold, almost illegal, and it's all Pokey's High Flyer to win it. Mystic Gold gets up for second, almost illegal third.
So from the top down, it'd be 2-3-1.
Number one, Jeremy Chubb, $10 fine for knocking that pylon down.
Hey, we got a fine on Jeremy Chubb.
Is he okay?
Are you guys okay?
Same damn thing hey, happened again.
Devon, are you guys okay?
Is this
okay?
To the point of embarrassment yet, or?
Yeah.
Okay, all right.
Ready to win? Yeah. All right, they should be bringing Pokey's High Flyer.
Heading trackside, winning tonight's fourth race in the closing strides. The three, Pokey's High Flyer. This is a two-year-old son, a Pokemon out of the Premier Princess. Owned, trained, and driven to the victory by Jeremy Delagrange. Here's your placings, race four, Mystic Gold two, almost illegal three, Pokey's High Flyer the winner, My Sass is Red six, Adelaide four, GV Cheyenne five. From the top down, 2-3-1-6-4-5.
All right.
Quarter was paced in 38 seconds, 38. Time of the win, 114, 1/5. Time of the second horse, 114 and 4. Time of the third horse, 115, 1/5. Upcoming race 5, no changes.
All right. Race 5 is slower. To 140.1. Okay, I can't do it as good as what Anthony does. Yeah, Poker's a pretty good crowd here tonight. It's really a good crowd. They're all spread out. And don't forget, if you need some feed for the horses, go see Anthony at one of the feed services here over in Shipshawana. I think he's got some horse horse food for the horses. He's kind of busy right now, but... All right. I have a field of three here for race five. So what are they? So what are they doing here?
The what?
Oh gosh! Oh brother! Okay, it's not one thing, something else. Starting car's got a problem now.
Here are the horses for race five. Race five. These are qualifying trotters. No changes here. Field of three. The one is Grace Lightning, owned by the Hostline Stables. Todd Hosteller drives. Two, K's Little Chance, owned by the Double M Stables with Gary Roth. And the three, JR Flying Dust, owned by the KDB Racing Stable. Kyle Bontrager is in the sulky. Field of three. Once again, drivers, we're not going to have a starting car for this race. We're all going to have to start on the one horse.
So this is going to be interesting. It took out a what?
Probably knocked that pile on. It's still laying there.
I don't know if it did or not.
Oh, great. Okay.
I don't know. That's what Mark said.
So we could have a very interesting night tonight. We gotta get through two more races, then we'll have a break, so. So this is gonna be interesting. I haven't seen this done before, so. This will be different, something new. All right, coming around turn four.
Grace Lightning,
Alright, Grease Lightning is the winner, and JR Flying Dust is second, and K's Little Jewel is third. So top down would be 1-3-2. Oh, we got one more race coming up. And maybe no starting card.
143 and flat, and 145 and one. I don't know what it takes to make.
Huh? All right.
Where did you go to try to find?
Hi, Vern Hostower.
That's as good as a mile.
Yes, there is a lot of fans here, but you have to realize they're spread out.
You know, Mike, you want the placings, Mike?
I got them. 1-3-2?
1-3-2. Quarter was in 52 seconds. Time of the first horse, 1:38. Second horse, 1:43. Third horse, 1:45-1.
Perfect. You're good. You're good. Okay, but by the way, we have a Canadian person logging in.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Frederick from Canada is logged in. And Vern Hostower is in. And like I said, folks, the fans are here, but they're spread out. You know, if it's because, you know, the groups that know each other with the family are close, but other than that, they're really spread out. And we got a lot of dust going here. All right, we got one more race, then we got a break. So let's see here. Anyway, I'm not sure what's going on. We still have truck problems. Alright.
Here's your placings, race 5, ladies and gentlemen. Grease Lightning, the winner. K's Little Jewel, 3. JR Flying Dust, 2. 1-3-2. Quarter was trotted in 52 seconds, 52. Time of the win, 1:38. Time of the second horse was 1:43. Time of the third horse, 1:45. 1/5.
So, Frederick, how are things up in Canada? You're in Canada. Or you're in the Dominican Republic. I don't know, I can't remember. I think it's Canada.
Oh, no, I wouldn't have that.
Y'all up, drivers, bring them this way.
Yeah. So, Frederick is...
Really?
Sometimes they do.
Yeah, that's Canada. I think that's Canada. Yeah. I don't remember.
Maybe.
Here are your trotters for race number 6, parading to the post. Field of 5, there are no changes. The one is GV Pretty Sweet Bee, owned by GS Racing Stables with Brandy Reed. 2, Don't Miss That Joke, owned by the MR Stables of Goshen with Minnewiker. 3, I'm a Gonna Get You, owned by the Triple E Stables with Earl Yoder. 4GV Sir Hank, owned by Darren Lambright, Kevin Slaybars and the Sulky. And the 5 Midnight Breeze, owned by Little Dream Stables, Stephen Layman is in the Sulky. Field of 5 Trotters will be at the gate shortly.
Always that way. And if you look over there, it's always Yeah, I know. But see, they don't believe in it.
I know. We've done a couple of horse sales, and there was no one wearing masks.
Yeah. Now, I'm going to be interested to see what happens with this governor mandate deal.
Well, he had to change his orders.
Yeah, I see that.
To criminalize him.
Yeah, I see that. Because I get the press releases from the governor's secretary.
Yeah,
I don't know if you see me post them once in a while.
I do see stuff. Yeah.
All right.
All right, I have like a photographer at Royal Rat. I want to make sure when she takes my picture, she gets the good side. She didn't hear that, did she? Okay, she. Now she's back behind my vehicle. So, I think we don't have a truck, not yet.
Trotters have reached the gate. Gate is rolling.
All right, we do have a gate. Oh, we have a truck, okay.
Need a fan or something for this thing. Here they come. And they're off and trotting three across the track at the start. GV, Pretty Sweet B, rather, to the outside. I'm a gonna get you now sweeps to the lead. Don't miss that joke. To the inside is there in second. GV Sir Hank up and around there in third. GV Pretty Sweet B to the inside. Fourth, parked wide to the outside. Midnight Breeze is the trailer. Trotters are strung out here single file as they motor around that far turn. I'm a gonna get you on the engine. To the inside, Iker has don't miss that joke there in the second, the sleigh ball with GV Sir Hank underway there. Third, opening quarter was 40 seconds. Back to the inside. They're in fourth, Midnight Breeze and the trailer GV Pretty Sweet Me as they storm out of that first turn and down the back stretch. Second and final time. I'm gonna get you on the front. Don't miss that joke. Rallying back to the inside in second, Midnight Breeze follows in third. Off stride, GV Sir Hank is fourth and the GV Pretty Sweet B as they head around that far turn and head past the stand second and final time. I'm a gonna get you is much the best here in the sixth. Midnight Breeze will get up for a second. Don't miss that joke third, and we have nothing.
Okay. And we have a microphone that went out. So we know I'm going to get you was the winner. The microphone went out perfect time. Well, not really, but you gotta. And you, I'm going to get you to come in the water circle.
Into the winner's circle, the 3, I'm going to get you. 2-year-old colt sired by Jandai New York Jets. Out of the mare, I'm a little faster. Owned by the Triple E Stables, the Masterpiece Meadows Trains, Earl Yoder is your winning driver. Time of the win, 120, 4-5.
That's all that counts. Go! Got it.
What are we going for up there? I don't know.
Here's your results, race 6, ladies and gentlemen. GB Pretty Sweet B, 4 placed 5 for excessive braking. Don't miss that joke 3. I'm gonna get you the winner. GB Sir Hank, 5 placed 4. Midnight Breeze 2. So from the top down, 5, 3, 1, 4, 2.
All right.
Yeah. Fractional times, the quarter was trotted in 40 seconds. Time of the wind, 1:20, 4/5. All right, Michael, time of the wind, 1:20, 4/5. Time of the second horse, 1:21 and 4. Time of the third horse, 1:22, 2/5.
Gotcha. Thank you, sir. All right. I think we're going to go on the... I think we're going on the break now. Anthony, we're going on the break? Okay. All right. We're going on the break right now, and we hopefully will have things taken care of when we come back for race 7. It'll be about a 20, 25-minute break, maybe a half hour. I don't know. So stay tuned. We'll watch it. We'll be back here in about, I'm going to say, 20, 25 minutes. As soon as I find what I need. There we go.
This is Dave Ramsey here to talk about Rain Drain. Rain Drain is your local dealer for the amazing Leaf Guard no-clog gutter system. Leaf Guard is the only seamless one-piece leaf protection system on the market today. It's a patented system that's built to stay clog-free, guaranteed. Or Rain Drain will clean your gutters for free. To learn more, call Rain Drain at 888-611-RAIN or visit them at raindraininc.com.
Well, they got the speaker working, but how long will it be working? We're gonna keep. Now what are you bringing me? Oh, the fan. Okay, I already said, what are you bringing me? I make enough high air. I don't need a bull anymore. Here, you want to do this? You want to do this for me? Hey, do you walk hood up? Would rain should get all in? What? Have to walk hood, could you would rain should get all in? Well, folks, you may not have to hear me call a race. Anthony may be calling the next race. As we race 7 with Dream Priceless, Soaring Eagle. You got one of your horses in this race?
I don't think so. I don't know.
Amber Raiden. Snooze got the look. Marty's little Lester. Chewin' making it crazy? No, but yours. GB Freaky Friday? Well, we got one more. M's what a. Okay, all right. Alright. Yeah. Gotta put the headset on. I'm just telling my audience that. That's all I'm doing. We got to hear the when the fee service call. When the fee service calls the next race. That's when the fee service and chips won up for the call of the next race. For all your horse needs and somebody brought me a hat. Gosh, I'm trying!
You don't know what you're talking about. Come on, Mike. Water feed service has more than horse feed.
Okay!
We got all kinds of feed. You come to water feed service for any of your feed.
How about cat feed? Andy didn't hear that. See, Anthony runs one of the peace service, so that's why I've... And he's got... I wonder how his... drive-through pickup is going. But yeah, folks, yeah, they have more than just horse feed there. They've got, I've been over there, they got bird feed, or cat, they got whatever you need to feed your animal, they got it. I guess that's making it real general. That's one of peace service and Chipshawana. Right close to Forks County Line Store. Okay, I said all the animals. Is that okay? Yeah, okay. I should have PA. Okay, yeah, all right. We'll find out a little bit. The PA's still working. I thought the horses were up in the next race. Yeah, they are. They're coming. They're parading. All right. We're getting ready for race 7. Yeah, whatever feed you need, go to one of feed services and get it. I don't, for any animal you need it for. If Anthony doesn't have it, he can get it. Now we're waiting on. I don't know. He's out here killing time.
Well, no. Did you say something to me?
Well, we got that.
Larry was up here working on
the. He's on his way. I got to
turn this. Yeah, turn the mic on, yeah?
He's on the track, drivers, bring him this way.
Okay, we're in the driver, okay. Hey, now we're getting someplace.
Pacers are on the track here for tonight's 7th race. Senior Pacers, 110 and 1 to 112. The one is Dream Princess, owned by the Grandview Stables and the Windy Brook Stables with Larry Weaver. 2, Soaring Eagle, owned by the Rocky Ridge Stables, Kevin Bontrager's your catch driver. 3 is Amber Rated, owned by the Hoosier Racing Stables with Jeremy Miller. 4, She's Got the Look, owner-driver Jay Christer of Middlebury. 5, Marty's Little Esther, owner-driver Chris Eicher Jr. 6, Jamaican Me Crazy, owned by the Grandview Stables with Sarah Weaver. 7, GV Freaky Friday, owned by Wayne Fry, Lauren Bontrager's in the sulky. And the 8, MI's What a Commotion, owned by Eddie Roke of Bermuda, David Miller, is in the sulky. Field of 8 will be at the gate in 1 minute.
Yeah, I know. I'm hearing it pretty good through the wireless. That was the best thing that ever had. I mentioned something, and 2 people from out of state donated money to get this. Well, it's real helpful.
Yeah. All right, I think we're ready. I don't know. I know they're going to the gate. So you will hear me. You will not hear me call this one. Anthony will call this one. I'm ready to call one.
Starter calls.
All right.
Full Field of 8 Senior Pacers head out of the turn for the start. It's post time. Here they come. And they're off in pacing Dream Princess. First to leave from the far outside. She's Got the Look from the inside. Marty's Little Esther slipping through to the inside. In fourth, Jamaican Me Crazy. Soaring Eagle settles in line there. In fifth, underway to the outside. There in six comes Amber Rated as they head around the far turn. It's all Jay Christner, and She's Got the Look by 2. Dream Princess to the inside. Follows along there in second, Jamaican Me Crazy. Gaps a wee bit there. In third, as they reach the quarter in 34 seconds. Leading them there, She's Got the Look to the inside. Dream Princess stalking the leader. And now first up to the outside, Jamaican Me Crazy is underway from third. Back to the inside there.
here in the fourth. Ember-rated GV Freaky Friday to the outside as they reach the upper turn. It's all She's Got the Look. Dream Princess to the inside. To the outside, Jamaica Be Crazy as they hit the stretch. It's She's Got the Look. She's Got the Look under a hand drive to win it. It'll be tight for a second between Jamaica Be Crazy and Dream Princess.
All right, She's Got the Look won that. That's a one apiece of this winner called by Anthony. So now let me see if I can get something going here. We're gonna try something. See if this will do. See if this will kick in. So far, nope.
Heading trackside, winning tonight's seventh race. Never an anxious moment here. The four She's Got the Look. Three-year-old filly, sired by the world champion GV Sir Tux out of the Mercedes Grand Libby. Owned, trained, and driven to the victory by Mr. J. Christner. Time of the win, 1:11.35. Here are your placings for race number 7, Dream Princess 3, Soaring Eagle 6, Amberated 5, She's Got the Look the winner. Marty's Little Esther 8, Jamaican Be Crazy 2, GV Freaky Friday 4, MI's What a Commotion 7. From the top down, 3, 6, 5, 1, 8, 2, 4, 7. Time of the quarter. The quarter was paced in 34 seconds. 34. Time of the win, 1:11.35. Time of the second horse was 1:13. Time of the third horse, also 1:13.
Thanks, Judy. I will. Hey, Anthony. Judy says you sound good. Yes, trust me, you get a compliment from Judy, you take it.
I appreciate that very much, Judy. Thank you for listening.
There you go. Got it from Anthony.
In the upcoming race number 8, ladies and gentlemen, we have a driver change on the 6th Little Red Rocket to Virgil Slaybaugh. Virgil Slaybaugh on the 6th. Little Red Rocket, looking for a field of 6. These are junior free-for-all trotters. Drivers, you're all out.
Okay, Judy, how would you rate Anthony to Nathan? The same? Well, I do.
Get up, Bob.
Well, if Judy's here... Okay, I'm gonna shut up.
I can't
We don't have a problem down there, do we? Here are the trotters for race number 8. The one is Jandai I Must Start 2, owned by the GS Racing Stables, John Granger Drives. Two is Blue Meadow Dreamer, owned by the Little Dream Stables with Steve Lehman. Three, Miso Fancy, owned by the Masterpiece Meadows, Earl Yoder Drives. 4, Check Me Out, owner-driver Seth Miller. 5, Cherokee's Nation, owned by Mike Slaybaugh and Brenda Troyer with Andrew Miller. And the 6, Little Red Rocket, owned by the Winding Brook Stables, Virgil Slaybaugh is in the sulky. We starting without it?
Devon, do we need to start without the...
Drivers just holding that turn there for a moment, please.
Start without the truck, because the truck got the hood up. Man, when it rains, it pours. Is the PA system or is the car? Yeah, I agree. It's gonna be a long night. And we're not even halfway through yet. And I'm not gonna say what I'm thinking. If I do, it's gonna happen. I don't know what's going on. All right. Yeah, that's at the gate, and the gate's moving.
And trotting and rough gated at the start, Jandai Ima Star 2 out for the lead, Blue Meadow Dreamer. Blue Meadow Dreamer clears to the lead by 4. To the inside there in second, here comes Little Red Rocket from the back row. To the inside, to the outside, Check Me Out is there in third, Cherokee's Nation underway from fourth. Me So Fancy off stride there in fifth, and the trailer Jandai Ima Star 2. Trotters are single file as they head past the stands to the quarter mile marker. Blue Meadow Dreamer leads him there to the quarter, and now to the outside with a quarter move. Here comes Sleigh Ball with Little Red Rocket. The opening quarter was 37 seconds. Back to the inside. Check Me Out is there in third. Tipping out now. Too wide comes Cherokee's Nation underway from fourth. Now the backstretch. Second and final time. Blue Meadow Dreamer to his wheel to the outside. Here comes Little Red Rocket 2. And flushing with that outer flow comes Cherokee's Nation underway from third. Out of the far turn. And down the stretch they come. Blue Meadow Dreamer to the outside, Little Red Rocket will rush. Little Red Rocket will not reach. Blue Meadow Dreamer gets up to win it.
All right. Race 9 coming up, and we're halfway. We're just going to get down with race 9.
What else? 6-1 what? I can't remember what quarter was.
6-1-5.
Okay. We good? 4-3-2. 6-1-5. 4-3-2. 37. Got it?
Heading trackside, winning tonight's eighth race, gate-to-wire fashion here, the 2 Blue Meadow Dreamer. This is a 4-year-old gelded son of Midnight Cruise, out of the mare Dreams Little Girl, owned and trained by the Little Dream Stables, driven to the victory tonight by Steve Lehman. Sixth win here on the season for the 2 Blue Meadow Dreamer, tying his lifetime best of 116 for the win.
Hey, Ron.
Here's your results. Race 8, Jandai Ima Star 2-6, Blue Meadow Dreamer the winner. Me So Fancy 5, Check Me Out 4, Cherokee's Nation 3, Little Red Rocket 2, From the Top Down 615-432. The quarter was trotted in 37 seconds, 37. Time of the win, 116. Time of the second horse, 116-1. And time of the third horse, 117.25. In the upcoming race nine, ladies and gentlemen, we have a scratch the 2WB Mr. Brownstone. The 2 is out sick. Looking for a field of 5. Drivers, you're all out.
All right, drivers are all out.
A valid question.
Pacers are on the track here for tonight's ninth race. These are sophomore Pacers. The 2 has been scratched. The 1 Time Goes On, owned by Dean Christner and Chip Shawana, Jeremy Miller drives. 2 is scratched. 3, GV Cash Money, owner-driver Elson Miller of LaGrange. 4, Rockin' Your Mama, owned by Elson Miller, Dale Miller drives. 5, Surprising Gold, owned by the Grandview Stables and the Winding Brook Stables with Larry Weaver. And the 6, MIs, One Last Time, owned by Eddie Roque of Bermuda, David Miller is in the sulky. Field of 5, sophomore Pacers will be at the gate in 1 minute.
You know what you're doing? Well, I'm sorry, you know. I had water going that way, I had water going that way, but you get back in there. Oh, okay. Now, tomorrow night, you can have my most shot. Tonight, no. All right, yep, getting to the gate. The gate's moving. All right, here we go.
Three on the gate, 2 trailers. Here they come. They're off in pacing, and first away, Time Goes On. For the lead, Surprising Gold to the inside. Slipping through to the inside, Rockin' Your Mama is there in third to the outside. GV Cash Money is fourth. After a miscue at the start, there, Rockin' Your Mama, rather, is the trailer. As they speed down the backstretch to that upper turn, and Time Goes On is on the engine. Surprising Gold to the inside follows along there in second. So as they hit single file here, no movers, as they reach the quarter mile marker. Up front for the lead, Time Goes On. The opening quarter was 40 seconds. Surprising Gold to the inside is there in second. MI's One Last Time to the inside is there in third. GV Cash Money follows in fourth. Rockin' Your Mama, the trailer, down the backstretch. Second and final time. Lead change up front here as... Jeez, a P. Surprising Gold comes after the leader. Surprising Gold on front by a length to the inside. Time Goes On, rallying right back as they head for home. It's all Surprising Gold driving right on by. Surprising Gold will win it.
All right, Surprising Gold won it. And I couldn't quite get to see who got second. We're getting from Anthony when... Now, Supply and Gold getting ready to be met here at the winner's circle.
Heading trackside, winning tonight's ninth race in the closing strides here, the five Surprising Gold. Two-year-old son of Gold Chip out of the mare, What a Surprise, owned by the partnership of the Grandview Stables and the Winding Brook Stables, trained by the Grandview Stables. Larry Weaver's your winning driver. Second win on the freshman campaign for the five Surprising Gold as he paced the quarter mile in 116 flat. Here's your results. Time goes on, 3-2 is scratched. GV Cash Money, 4. Rockin' Your Mama, 5. Surprising Gold, the winner. MI's One Last Time, 2. From the top down, 3. Scratch, 4. 5. 1-2. Quarter. The quarter was paced in 40 seconds. 40 seconds. Time of the win, 1:16. Time of the second horse was 1:16 and 2. Time of the third horse, 1:16 4/5. In the upcoming race 10, we have a post entry at the 7 ML Legacy. At number 7, ML Legacy, the driver Marcus Hostetler. Looking for a field of 7. Heavy driver back to back. He'll be out just a moment.
All right. Back to back.
Somebody said a little bit ago.
Derek
Lee?
Derek
Lee?
Bruce? All right, Derek. Let's see here, let me see. Dale Miller. Let's see here, who else? The Reader? Nope. Well, we'll find out when Anthony makes the call. All right. Well, Mary Beth must be out someplace tonight. I haven't seen anything from her, so. So this is my call out to Mary Beth. Judy, if you're still listening, tell Mary Beth that she's getting called out. I don't know what for her, but I'm calling her out. You probably what? Probably on. Okay.
The one is Electric Sensation, owned by Esther Eicher. Derek Lee drives. 2, Yobro Impact, owned by David Burrows. Dale Miller drives. 3, Hoosier Gold, owned by the Sundown Stables with John Gingrich. 4, Betts Big Kid, owned by the Indian Creek Stables of Middlebury with Bill Beachy. 5, Malibu Shadow, owned by the Younger Brothers Racing Stables with J.R. Stutzman. 6, Skyway Fantastic, owned by Joni Beachy. Joni Beachy drives. And the 7 ML Legacy, the driver, Marcus Hostetler. Field of 7, Junior Free-for-All Pacers will be at the gate in less than a minute.
All right, here, your Coppins Commons, race number 10. Coppins Commons, we have the ITPA banquet later in the year. I don't know. Are you talking about me? Was somebody talking about me up there?
I just heard him say something about
Jonah. Oh, okay. All right, that's a gate and gets moving.
Junior free-for-all Pacers are lining up, moving in. All set, and they're off. First to leave, Electric Sensation, Hoosier Gold to the outside. ML Legacy, forwardly placed to the inside, gets away there in third. Skyway Fantastic to the inside, fourth. Slipping through to the inside, Bet's Big Kid is there in fifth. Malibu's Shadow is underway after some trouble at the start there. In the sixth, your early trailer, Yo Bro Impact, as they speed around the far turn and head past the stands. Derek Lee has Electric Sensation on the engine. To the outside, Hoosier Gold is there first to go from second. Opening quarter, 34 seconds. ML Legacy to the inside, third. Off stride now, back pacing again there. In fourth comes Skyway Fantastic. To the inside, Bet's Big Kid is fifth, followed by Malibu's Shadow. Down the backstretch to the far turn, Electric Sensation. To the outside, Hoosier Gold with a rush. And off his back, going three wide, comes ML Legacy. Out of the turn, Electric Sensation from the center of the pack. Hoosier Gold, Hoosier Gold gets up to win it. ML Legacy will get up for second, followed by Electric Sensation, and we are gone.
Yeah, don't waste the money, then. Well, the nice thing is, we have one, two races until the break. By the way, Judy, I'm sorry. I thought you were in Illinois, and I got you and Mary Beth mixed up, so that's my bad. I keep forgetting. So I said, you didn't get my Golden Boys yet. We'll have 18 more races tomorrow night. If everything goes right. I heard something.
Heading trackside, winning tonight's 10th race, the three Hoosier Gold. In the closing stride, this is a three-year-old filly sired by Soaring Gold, her first win, M3. She's owned by the Sundown Stables, also trained by the Sundown Stables, driven to the victory by John Gingrich. Here's your placing, race 10, Electric Sensation 3, Yo Bro Impact 7, Hoosier Gold the winner, Bet's Big Kid 4, Malibu Shadow 6, Skyway Fantastic 5, ML Legacy 2, 3, 7, 1, 4, 6, 5, 2. Quarter. The quarter was paced in 34 seconds, 34. Time of all three horses, 1, 2, and 3, 110, 3 fifths. 110 and 3 for all three. 34. Upcoming race 11, there are no changes. We have a driver back-to-back. Looking for a field of six, we've got five. Five out. What do you got, one?
Sunshine.
You know, try going back to back. It's going to take a little bit to get to the next, get to the next horse. Depending on where he's at. Alright. Said, what a piece of this, and Sip Shawana been sponsoring all the harness races ever since we started doing this, and next year, the way it sounds, folks, we're going to do a little traveling with harness races. That's the way it's sounding. We may be all over the state. Not in Spinal yet, but I've heard some of the places that we could be doing them from, and it's some pretty top flight facility. Yep. Bring him over to parade.
Here come the Pacers for race number 11. These are junior free-for-all Pacers. Field of six, no changes. The one is IC's Precious Time over the KDB Racing Stable with Kyle Bontrager. Two, Scarlet Flair, owned by the Miller Racing Stables with Derek Lee. Three, Rockin' in Paradise, owned by the Triple C Racing Stables with Earl Yoder. Four, GV Emily Rose, owned by the Hoosier Racing Stables, Matt Miller Drives. Five, Hilltop Serena, owner-driver Willis Slaybaugh. And the six, Hilltop Billy Frost, owner-driver Rose Bontrager. Field of six, junior free-for-all Pacers will be at the gate in 1 minute.
What time? Turn the lights on.
Yeah, I was just noticing my pictures are getting
kind of dark.
I get
a bump. Well, open the shutter up a little bit.
Well, I've been switching them at each race.
Yeah. All right. Oop. Yep, gates moving. Coming around turn four. I'm on turn one. And coming down the front stretch.
Pacers have reached the stretch. Four and two, here they come. And they're off. Scarlet Flair, first to leave IC's Precious Time. To the inside there in third, Hilltop Serena. Outside, parked wide, Rockin' in Paradise is there. Fourth to third, slipping through now to the inside, Hilltop Billy Frost is there in fifth. And your early trailer is GV Emily Rose as they head around the far turn and head past the stands to the quarter mile marker. Derek Lee and Scarlet Flair has made the engine to the inside. IC's Precious Time. They're in second, opening quarter, 33 seconds back to the inside. Rockin' in Paradise third. Hilltop Billy Frost the Gray is there in fourth. Hilltop Sarita follows in fifth, and the trailer GV Emily Rose down the backstretch second and final time. Scarlet Flair under submerging here to the inside. IC's Precious Time gaining with every stride with less than a 16th to go. It's Scarlet Flair, IC's Precious Time to the grandstand side. Scarlet Flair, IC's Precious Time coming to him. These two are together. Looks like Scarlet Flair held on to win it.
Well, all I see is Twister Call. If it was Scarlet Flair, that would be Dairy Queen. So Grandma would be happy. So we'll find out. We'll see what the tape says. It looks like Jerry's bringing the horse in, so.
Eleventh race, the two Scarlet Flair, gate to wire fashioned here. This is a 2-year-old filly sired by One Cool Machine out of the mare Scarlet Code. Owned by the Miller Racing Stables, trained by Nathan Miller, Derek Lee's your winning driver. Seventh win on the freshman campaign for this 2-year-old filly, Scarlet Flair, as she paced the quarter mile in 109 flat.
Not a bad time. Yeah, Scarlet Flair. 109 flat.
Here's your results for race 11, IC's Precious Time 2, Scarlet Flair the winner, Rocketed Paradise 3, GV Emily Rose 6, Hilltop Serena 5, Hilltop Billy Frost 4. From the top down, 213-654. Fractional times here, the quarter was paced in 33 seconds, 33. Time of the win, 109. Time of the second horse, also 109. Time of the third horse was 110, 4/5. Upcoming race 12, looking for a field of 5. Driver change of the 6, Delightful Bow to Richard Stutzman. Richard Stutzman drives the 6.
All right, race 12 coming up.
You're allowed, drivers. You did. Here are the horses for race 12, freshman pacers. These are 118 and 123 pacers. The one is WB Thunderstruck, owned by the Winding Brook Stables with Andrew Miller. 2 Heart Attack, owned by the Triple C Racing Stables with Dale Miller. 4 Miss Liberated, owned by the Little Dream Stables with Steve Lehman. 5 Yo Bro Passion, owned by the Sundown Stables with John Gingrich. And the 6 Delightful Bow, owned by the Younger Brothers Racing Stables, Richard Stutzman, is in the sulky. Excuse me. Field of 5, and we are cooked.
All right. And I think we're about due for the lights.
He said right after the
break, just
turn them on.
So during the break, you can turn them on. Okay.
You must have pulled some strings to get it done.
I just said something when he was sitting there.
Oh, okay.
I was talking to Mark.
Okay.
I didn't even
look
up.
Okay.
All right, I guess the lights are going to go on after this race and the break. And the truck's moving.
3 and 2. Here they come.
Go.
And they're off in pacing. WB Thunderstruck gets the call from the inside. Yobro Passion to the outside. Heart Attack. As they all bunch up here, in and around that first turn, they're three deep. And up front for the lead, Heart Attack. But slipping through from in between horses, Yobro Passion takes the lead. Block to the inside, WB Thunderstruck. And to the outside, still three wide, Delightful Bow. As they head around the far turn, and head past the stands to the quarter mile station. It's Yobro Passion on the engine, still three wide, Heart Attack from in between horses, and Delightful Bow with a determined drive to the outside. Opening quarter was in 40 seconds, back to the inside, WB Thunderstruck is there in fourth, Miss Liberated on a break there, as they head down the back stretch, second and final time. It's Yobro Passion, and now to the outside, Delightful Bow takes the lead. Delightful Bow powers on by as they come to the 16th pole. Delightful Bow to the inside, Yobro Passion rallying right back here. Heart Attack can see them all in third, but as they hit the line, it's all Delightful Bow. Delightful Bow will win it. Yobro Passion gets up for second, Heart Attack third.
All right, Delightful Bow won race 12. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We've got 6 more races. If I were to break in to get the horses warmed up, because if I remember, if I looked at it right. Oh, yeah, we got some fast horses coming up. I mean, we got some really fast horses coming up. Oh, God. We got probably the best of the best coming up. Hey, the lights are on!
Heading trackside, winning tonight's 12th race. In come from behind fashion, the 6th Delightful Bow. Two-year-old filly, sired by Gold Chip, Adelmer Barnabo. Owned and trained by the Younger Brothers Racing Stables, Richard Stutzman is your winning driver. Race 12, WB Thunderstruck 5, Heart Attack 3, Miss Liberated 4, Yobro Passion 2, Delightful Bow the winner. 5, 3, 4, 2, 1. Fractional times, the quarter was paced in 40 seconds. Time of the win, 1:16, 3 fifths. Time of the second horse, 1:17 and 4. Time of the third horse, also 1:17, 4 fifths. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have our last quick intermission here. Do a little track maintenance. We'll be right back with you here very shortly. We'll be bringing race 13 on the track to finish us out here this evening. Also have an announcement, horsemen. Just a reminder that the Indiana Breeders sale consignment forms are due next Saturday. That's August the first, due next Saturday to Lisa Lowe,
and we are freaking
we're gone
again.
Yep, we're gone. All right, so we're gonna take a break, folks, while we get the PA taken care of. So anyone know who won race? Hang on a minute, Judy. Race 2, Pistol Pack and Mama won race 2. I don't have the times, but Pistol Pack and Mama won race 2. So you must have a sheet, so you see what's going on. Hey, I like that. And for race 2, the placement was 4-1-3-5-2 from top down. 4-1-3-5-2 from top down. So Pistol Pack and Mama one race two. So we'll see you in a little bit.
We'll be right back. Congratulations, Power Rangers. Victory is yours. You have gone far beyond the call of duty and saved your world from a terrible fate. The world is very lucky to have you, and so am I.
Power Rangers!
Softener system from Hawkins Water Tech. There's nothing hard about it. Just give us a call and we'll give your hard, slurry water the Hawkins treatment. That means cleaner dishes while using less dish soap. Superior sales, service, and salt delivery. Hawkins Water treats you better. Visit HawkinsWater.com.
Alright, we're back here to the Range County 4-H Playgrounds. Next Friday night, folks, it's Jayco night. I'm just, Anthony. Friday night. Okay. I didn't know you're talking. So I'm. Okay. Next weekend is it's Jayco night here. I don't know if it's Friday or Saturday. I forget. I went. And then on Saturday night, we had a 3/4 mile race that. Gonna be pretty good. But then they have what the 5/8 race was down at Napier Raceway. Those horses can get up and they can go. Alright. Are we getting ready? Alright. 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 Race 13's kind of, and I can't find it in my pen. Race 13, the field of five. So I said, next weekend's going to be a big weekend here at the Range County 4-H Playgrounds. You got Jayco night, and you got the one of B service 3/4 mile race that is really going to be good. So, check out Jayco Travel Trailer dealer near you for your local Jayco Travel Trailer. Oh gosh, the hierarchy's going upstairs. This means something. I don't know what, but it means something. I gotta keep my mouth shut. So, yeah, all the hierarchy's going upstairs. That means we got problems. A me in their mind, I don't know. We got something going on upstairs. And by the way, folks, if you see cars over at Northridge tomorrow, they're having a chicken barbecue. Tickets are already pre-sold and they're sold out. So if you have a ticket, get there between 10:30 and 10:30 and 12:05
and what?
Somewhere in that area.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you could direct your attention to the winner's circle.
Okay.
If you followed racing last year, you would have known that a more than 30-year record was broken right here in September. We're unveiling a new sign here, ladies and gentlemen, set by GV Jokers Drew.
Oh, okay.
Who crushed a time of 107 that was set by Summertime some 30 years ago, was broken last year. 105-3 is your new all-time trotting record here at LaGrange. Congratulations once again to the Connections, Bruce Wyman, Three Rivers, Michigan, and GV Jokers Drew. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a hand here for those Connections?
All right. You're getting bacon. He must want his money. I'll take part of that.
He's on his way, drivers. Line him up. Parade and password, please.
I would have said something when you said, I offered to have some plug into this and then run it for here.
Here come the horses for the 13th, our last leg of the program this evening. Got a field of five. These are senior free-for-all pacers parading to the post. The one is Jeans Showboy, owned by the Rocky Ridge Stables with Jason Yoder. Two Cool Thunder, owned by Bruce Wyman, Luke Miller drives. Three is Scratched. Four Modest Girl, owner-driver Darren Bontrager. Five GB Special Rate, owned by the Hoosier Racing Stables with Jeremy Miller. And the six Cyberwave, owned by the Younger Brothers Racing Stables, J.R. Stutzman, is in the sulky. Field of five, senior free-for-all pacers will be at the gate shortly.
I was trying to compare you three, and it's like, because I hope that PA would still screwed up, I would end up calling for the races. And you know how
I heard you say that. I was like, yeah, you should, I think.
I think August 7th, when we're back in Appanee, I'm going to sit on the other side, and the only question mark I've got is if the wireless will reach. And I want to get down there early and check that.
You have the other one with you?
I got the other one in the truck, but I don't want to mess that stuff. This has been a weird night.
I was going to say, because I could almost go over.
Don't worry about it right
now.
I don't want to mess anything up. But well, I'm still going to put the proposal together, and I'm going to, if everything goes right.
Starting eight rolling, it's post time. Recall race 13.
One Illinois kind of concert. Warsaw, Kendallville, back here for the fair.
Oh, we got a recall. Or otherwise I call it false start.
That's true.
Well, it's the same thing, isn't it?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah. Well, wait, every time you call a recall, I said, okay, we got a false start.
Yeah. I was saying, yeah, that makes the same difference.
Yeah, it's the same thing. But I mean, I want to
thank
you.
Thank you.
Recall charged the one. Gene's cheer boy. He must move to the back row.
Thanks for putting that ad in the program.
Oh, for you?
Yes.
Okay.
Which I didn't realize you guys did it. And I'm going to give you guys, when we go back down on Anthony, I'm going to have a card with me. I'm going to give you that so you got all the information. Okay. Okay. So we do that next year. But, because I'm already working on next year's stuff. You don't want to see what's planned for next year. If you think this year's something, wait till. Well, my ultimate goal is to get 500 sponsors and be like Fox News. That is my ultimate goal. Because you've seen all of that crap that's been on Facebook and stuff about the virus deal.
Yeah.
And
is this one
racist? Yeah, I got a
13, okay.
Three of the gates, two trailers, the five has elected to move up into the stretch, nearing the start. Here they come. And they're off in pacing, and it's Cruel Thunder first to leave. Bonnet's Girl to the outside, to the inside. Cyberwave gets away there in third. Off stride, Gene Showboy fourth, and the trailer is Cruel Thunder as they head down the backstretch for the first time, and up front for the lead, it's all Modest Girl. Modest Girl is on the engine as they head past the stands at the quarter mile marker, and that's up front for the lead. Opening quarter was 33 seconds, and it's Modest Girl on the front. Cruel Thunder to the inside. Off stride there in second. Cyberwave gets away there. Third, Gene Showboy. Fourth, down the backstretch. Second and final time. Modest Girl. Cruel Thunder with some whip urging here to the outside. It is gaining with every stride. With less than a 16th to go. Modest Girl. Cruel Thunder as well. Out of the far turn. It's all Modest Girl. Cruel Thunder to the grandstand side, goes right on by in deep stretch. Cruel Thunder gets up to win it. God.
So, and do you have any more special nights down, Anthony, coming up? I know you guys said it on August 7th. Well, the memorial, the memorial race.
Memorial, and also Dr. Randolph or something. He's going to sponsor the whole night.
Oh, he is?
Yeah, he's going to, like, pass money to the races and stuff, yeah. So that'll be, and that's all the same night, August 7th.
Okay, because
so
that's, okay, because yeah. what I'm thinking is sit on the other side and do Facebook Live for some of the races. Yeah. As long as, because the crowd down there is fantastic.
Oh, yeah. This is a really good crowd for here. Normally, we don't have that many here, it seems like.
Well.
It looks pretty packed, I think.
Well, it was pretty packed earlier before the sun went down, so.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I'm feeling real good about the stuff I'm doing. Mm-hmm. You know, I've got the numbers and stuff on the website.
Uh-huh.
I'm closing in on 1,000 for listening to the harness. Yeah.
Heading back trackside, winning tonight's 13th in the closing strides, the two Cruel Thunder.
Well, Nathan, thanks. And,
6-year-old gelded son of the world champion GB Stuck Tux on their way to Cruel by Worthy Way. Owned by the mayor, Bruce Wyman of Three Rivers, Michigan, trained and driven to the victory by Luke Miller. Third win here at 6 for Cruel Thunder as he paced the quarter mile in 109.45.
I'm going to have to look at it because he might have threw in some steps. I didn't think.
Cruel Thunder won that.
We'll look at it.
Here's your placings. Race 13, Gene Showboy 4. Cool Thunder the winner. Black Beauty was scratched. Modest Girl 2, GB Special Rate 5. Cyberwave 3. Down 4, 253. These results, ladies and gentlemen, are unofficial. Here are your fractional times. The quarter was paced in 33 seconds. Time of the first and second horses, 109.45. Time of the third horse was 110. 4-1, scratch, 2-5-3.
Thank you, sir.
Great. Drivers, you're all out. Race 14, bring him this way.
All right. All right, race 14 coming up. Is this a little hit? Okay, then I'll be it up after this.
Whoever's on the review committee.
Okay. Here are your trotters for race 14. We've got a field of three. These are junior trotters. The one is WB Lotto Shuffle, owned by the Winding Brook Stables with Andrew Miller. Two Summer Breeze, owned by the MR Stables of Goshen with Derek Lee. And the three, Willie Be The One, owned by the GS Racing Stables, Brandy Reed, is in the sulky. Field of three junior trotters will be at the gate shortly.
So,
what do we call them? The review committee? What is it?
I don't like those drinks. You got
the wrong
myself.
The review committee. Okay, that's interesting. Go review that. They have a question about the next.
Also, we need the review committee to the judges after immediately following race 18 tonight. Need the review committee. After race 18.
What is your watch?
It's a Fitbit.
Oh, okay.
Junior trotters are all on behind the gate. All set. Off stride at the start, Willie Be The One. Off stride, WB Lido Shuffle. Out for the lead, Summer Breeze off stride. Trotters are bunched up here into the turn as they step to the backstretch for that first time, and Summer Breeze has made the front. To the inside, they're in a second. Comes WB Lido Shuffle. Will he be the one? Your trailer. Trotters are bunched up here now, tightly packed. As they hit around the far turn, Derek Lee has Summer Breeze in the clear. Will he be the one moves up to the outside. Back trotting again there in third, now off stride. There goes WB Lido Shuffle, and off stride, will he be the one? As they reach the quarter, the quarter was in 46 seconds. And just tooling along here, Summer Breeze, unchallenged at this point. Off stride, WB Lido Shuffle, will he be the one? Moves up to the outside. As they step to the backstretch, second and final time, Summer Breeze, never an anxious moment here, but now under submerging, here comes Will he be the one, and he goes off stride. Moving up and around, the WB Lido Shuffle, and he's off stride as well. So as they head around that far turn and head past the stand second and final time, it's all Summer Breeze. Summer Breeze, never an anxious moment here. She'll get up to win it. Will he be the one? We'll get up for second. WB Lido Shuffle third.
my... Let's check, I was sending a message to Judy. Hey, Judy, as you'll see, we've had mic problems all night tonight. It's been one of those strange nights.
I can't remember. I have to look. I think it's like $20, I think. Heading trackside, winning tonight's 14th race, Skate to Wire Fashion, the two Summer Breeze. Two-year-old filly, sired by Midnight Cruise, out of the mare Little Breeze, owned and trained by Meadow Acres MR Stables of Goshen, driven to the victory by Derek Lee.
Hey, Grandma, you got one.
Second win at two, the freshman campaign for Summer Breeze, as the filly trotted the quarter mile in 131 to 3/5. Here's your placings for race 14, WB Lido Shuffle 3, Summer Breeze the winner, Willie be the 1-2. Fractional times, the quarter was trotted in 46 seconds, 46. Time of the win, 131, 3/5. Time of the second horse was 135. Time of the third horse, 138, 1/5. Upcoming race 15, couple changes here. Driver change on the one, Pokey's Flyby to Kevin Bontrager. Kevin Bontrager on the one in the 15th. Also scratch the five, always a rockin'. The five is out sick. Looking for a field of five.
All right, Grandma, I hope you like that. That Derek won one, which I'm positive that you're listening, and no, you're past your bedtime yet, but, so you should be out there somewhere. Let me have a small break here. Let me say again, depending on what happens with high school sports, we're going as far as we can with the harness racing. We may end up doing the Breeders' Cup. I mean, that's a very good possibility.
Come on, drivers, bring them this way.
I mean, that's a very, very good possibility.
Here are the horses for race 15. These are senior free-for-all pacers. The five has been scratched. The one is Pokey's Flyby, owned by Gerald Delagrange of Millersburg, Kevin Bontrager drives. Two Western Terror, owned by Mark Beachy, Seth Millers, and the Sulky. Three Always Be Cool, owned by the Rocky Ridge Stables with Ryan Yoder. Four LK Billy's Bandit, owner driver Darren Bontrager. Five is scratched. And the six Hilltop Night Rage, owned by Pedigree Point Racing Ryan Miller, is in the sulky. Field of five. Fast Pacers will be at the gate in 1 minute.
Well, sorry, trying to get a message to Judy here.
Oh,
Radio Judy, he has the headpiece around his neck, and the mic is back a little bit from his mouth, so that might be part of it.
Starting eight rolling. Four rolling eight, one trailing starter. The Devon Miller starting eight is in the stretch, and here they come. And they're off and pacing four wide at the start. Hokies fly by. Western Terror, Always Be Cool, slipping through to the inside. Hilltop Night Rage, they're all bunched up. And off stride, LK Billy's Bandit Chitriller. As they head down the backstretch for that first time, and Bon Trigger has Pokies fly by in the clear by a half length. Parked wide to the outside comes Always Be Cool there in the second. Or Western Terror, rather, is there in second, slipping through to the inside. There, Hilltop Night Rage is third as they reach the quarter mile marker in 33 seconds. And it's Pokies fly by under heavy duress from Western Terror to the outside. And now Western Terror puts a nose in front. And drafting too wide now with that live cover flow, Hilltop Night Rage second over third. And back to the inside, Always Be Cool fourth as they reach the 16th pole. Pokies fly by and now to the outside, Western Terror and three wide. Here comes Hilltop Night Rage, and Hilltop Night Rage goes right on by in deep stretch. Two eyes.
Well, a little preview of what at the Rinch County 4-H Playground. I finally got Facebook Live to kick on. It's been not letting me do it all night. So we'll be here again tomorrow night with 18 more races. So, tomorrow night we start at 6, by approximately 5:50 we'll be on the air, and okay, all right, sorry Judy, I thank you, whoops, okay, wait a minute, all right Judy, I had my boy high, so that might have been a problem. So, as I said, we're here at the Napanee Race, LaGrange County 4-H Fairgrounds. And we have one person. Looking in. That's interesting. Oh, I have two. Oh, hello, Steve. Oh, no, back to one. Okay. If you can see through all those lights.
Heading trackside, winning tonight's 15th race. In dramatic fashion here, the closing strides, the six Hilltop Night Rage, 7-year-old son of Underestimated out of the Mare Night Express, owned and trained by Pedigree Point Racing. Ryan Miller is your winning driver. Second win here on the season for Hilltop Night Rage as he paced the quarter mile in 108.15. Here's your results. Pokies fly by 2, Western Terror 3, Always Be Cool 4, LK Belly's Bandit did not finish, Always a Rockin' Scratched, Hilltop Night Rage the winner. From the top down, 2, 3, 4, DNF, Scratch 1. Fractional times here, the quarter was based in 33 seconds. Time of the win, 1:08.15.
I just want to do a little
time of the second horse and third horses, both 1:09 flat.
All right, but back here at LaGrange.
Upcoming race 16, we have a field of two freshman trotters lined up here. There are no changes in the 16th. Drivers, you're all out.
What time is the band watch?
10 o'clock.
It's still early. All right. Well, Judy, I hope mine's better. I hope you see. I don't know. Judy, you don't have me on Facebook, do you? I don't think you do. Maybe you do. I don't know. I got so many on Facebook, I'm not sure who's what and where.
So I turned me down a little bit. Hopefully that's a little bit better. I mean, by the way, I'm eating a potato chip. So that's why it's going to crackle a little bit more. I'm having a potato chip. All right, here we go.
Freshman trotters have reached the tracker parading to the post for race 16. Field of two freshman trotters, there are no changes. The one is Noble Prince, owned by the Mulberry Hill Stables with J.R. Stutzman. And the five, Jets Road Runner, owned by the Skip and Go Stable. Lowayne Bontrager is in the sulky. Field of two trotters will be at the gate in 1 minute.
All right, we're going to try something. Yeah, let's see if I can make this work. All right, we're going to try something. I haven't done this. All right, I have a field of two here in race 16. So we'll see how what kind of results I get for this. They're headed for the starting gate truck, and that there's the truck right back there. So we'll see if they're heading for the truck.
Got equipment difficulties here.
Oh, we got to
be heading to the gate shortly.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I think I have equipment difficulties. We'll go back. Judy, I think it's the connections. I think that part of it's the connections, and part of it, the internet connection over here at LaGrange County Forest Fairground is not the best. So, by the way, Steve, I see you're looking. Hey, when are you gonna come to a harness race? Oh, not sure. Now you go off the air. Now you're off, Steve. Sure. I said, when do you come and do some harness races? You and Kim gotta get out of
there. We're all set to go here. The starter has called the horses.
All right, here we go. Horses are going to the gate, and there's the horses. And the gate's moving. Gotta get probably that's my vehicle, by the way. So we're gonna see how this works tonight. You should be coming out from behind my vehicle here in a little bit. I think. Yep, there he is. Yep, there he is. Hi, Sean. I was thinking about South Bend. Sure.
Field of two. 3-year-old colt trotters are lining up, moving in. And off stride at the start, Noble Prince. Out quickly for the lead, Jets Road Runner gets the call. To the inside, and Noble Prince gets away there, forwardly placed there in second as they charge in and around that first turn. Jets Roadrunner on the front, on the engine here. Noble Prince settles into the inside there in second. They're single file as they step to the back stretch for that first time to the upper turn. Jets Roadrunner and Lowayne Bontrager unchallenged on the lead. To the inside in second comes Noble Prince and J.R. Stutzman. He's gaining with every stride, though, as they swing out of that far turn and head past the stands to the quarter-mile station. Jets Roadrunner on the front here. Never an anxious moment yet, but Noble Prince is coming at him and coming on to the outside. The opening quarter was in 50 seconds, and it's Jets Roadrunner.
Noble Prince to his inside. As they head around the first turn and down the backstretch, second and final time, it's Jets Road Runner. Noble Prince winding up now to the outside as they hit the backstretch, second and final time towards that upper turn. Jets Road Runner, Noble Prince, putting on the pressure to the outside at the leader's wheel. It's Jets Road Runner, Noble Prince to the outside, and is now off stride. So as they hit the stretch, second and final time, it's all Jets Road Runner, Jets Road Runner, under a hand drive here. Noble Prince will get up for second.
All right. That's the end of that race. So let's see how the great experiment worked. All right. So that's just a little sample, folks, of Facebook Live that you're going to see on August 7th when we're back down at Amping. I said that's only a sample. We'll do better when we go down in Ampanee. We'll be sitting in a different position, so.
Heading trackside, winning tonight's 16th race in gate-to-wire fashion. The 5 Jets Road Runner, 3-year-old gelded son of Jandai New York Jet, out of the mare I'm a Little Faster, owned and trained by the Skip and Go Stable. Driven to the victory by LaWayne Bontrager. This is the first win at 3 for the 5 Jets Road Runner as he trotted the quarter mile in 139 at 2/5.
So again, let me tell you, the reason...
Here's your results for race 16, Noble Prince 2, Jets Road Runner the winner. Fractional times, the quarter was trotted in 50 seconds. Time of the win, 139.25. Time of the second horse was 140.45. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're down to our last two of the evening, two of our featured events on the card. 112 and Faster free-for-all trotters are winding up here next. Looking for a field of 6 in the upcoming 17th at the 6th Jandai Candy Time with Lauren Bontrager. Lauren Bontrager drives the 6th Jandai Candy Time in the upcoming race 17.
All right.
Drivers, you're all out.
Got the two features coming up. So we'll see how this pans out. So I said the internet connection over here at the Grange County Fairgrounds is not the best. That may be causing some of the problems. Maybe not all of it, but it's causing some of the problems. I did a few. Yeah, there we go.
Distaff trotters have made the track here, parading to the post for race 17. These are featured trotters here this evening. Field of 6, the one is Chris's Rock, owned by the Redneck Stables with Kevin Slaybaugh. 2, Yobro Dante, owner-driver Francis De Silva. 3, Cherokee's Promise, owner-driver Andrew Miller. 4, GV Brandon Brook, owned by Luke Miller and Joni Beachy. Joni Beachy drives. 5, GV Don't Miss a Beat, owned by Esther Iker. Chris Iker Jr. will drive. And the 6, Jandai Candy Time, the driver, Lauren Bontrager.
Field of Six. Some of the fastest trotters in the business are ready to duke it out here. They'll be at the gate in less than a minute.
Alright. Folks, if you have not seen harness races, you may want to witness this one. This one is going to be quick. It's going to be fast. These horses are going to move. And there's the starting truck over there on the far side. I mean, he'll probably get that starting truck going about 40, 50 miles an hour. Maybe, yeah, about that. And they're around turn two, head up to the gate, and the truck's rolling. That's it. These guys are going to move. If you've never seen harness races, these guys are going to get up, and they are going
to move. Trotters have reached the gate. Gate is rolling. Four on the gate, two trailing starters. These are free-for-all trotters lining up, moving in. And they're off in trotting. And out quickly and off stride goes Yo Bro Dante. From the outside, GB Brandon Brooks sweeps in and takes the lead. Off stride to the inside, Chris's Rock. And to the outside, moving up now, off stride, Jandai Candy Time. Back to the inside there. And now GB Don't Miss a Beat comes from the back. And now he's second as they are strung out badly here. They hit around that far turn and head past the stands to the corner. Quarter mile marker. In up front for the lead is GB Brandon Brook. GB Brandon Brook leads to the quarter. Quarter in 38 seconds. GV Brandon Brook hot on his heels. GV Don't Miss a Beat there in second. And coming from fourth to third to second as Jandai Candy Time with a rush putting the pressure on, but he is off stride. So as they head around that far turn, it's all GV Brandon Brook. GV Brandon Brook minding his manners here. GV Don't Miss a Beat to the inside. And it'll be a fight for place and show. But it's going to be all GV Brandon Brook taking the 17th.
All right, that is race 17. And the people logged in to see that live, well, I'll be back in a little bit. We'll see. I'm getting a few more to one. Hey, Mr. Bethany. Yeah, okay. So we'll be back here. Well, no, wait. We're gonna have the awards coming up, and then the countback. Hey, we have quite a few logging in. This ain't bad. Maybe I'm on to something here. Mr. Ray Caples, you ready for some softball? Probably you are. I know I'm ready. Miss Christner, I need to have a little chit-chat with you. I talked to your husband tonight. All right, here we go.
Heading trackside, winning tonight's free-for-all trot, second division. The four, GV Brandon Brook. This is a five-year-old gelded son of What a Joke, out of the Mare Brookside Missy, owned by Luke Miller and Joan Ibici. Joan Ibici trains and drives. Time of the win, 1:15.
All right. We should have Yep, we got one more race to go, and I want to see if somebody that, let me see here. Folks, if you can see it, that's the next race is coming up. And by the way, that's all my equipment. When I set up for a harness race here, that's all my equipment. So, okay, you got that. So we're...
is our featured event of the evening. These are 106 and faster. These are free-for-all pacers. No changes in the next race. Our finale of the evening. Hold on tight here. They'll be on the track momentarily.
Yeah, and trust me, Anthony means that. Hold on, because these guys are going to move. These horses will get up and go and move. And should be coming here for the parade here in a few minutes. I said, folks, I don't normally do this, so this is kind of an experiment to see how things pan out. So what are we? Are they? Oh, they're back on turn two. So don't forget, tomorrow night we'll be right back here to the Grange. And it'll be about 5:50. They're in the back stretch. I'm not sure what's going on. We got a, maybe the starter's truck. All right, just hang on here, folks. I said you can see the. Yep, there's the horses getting ready for the future race. And by the way, there's my vehicle. If anybody cares, which they probably don't. We'll see if I can. See what's going on with the I'm not sure what's going on. Honestly, trooper, I really don't know what's going on. I really don't.
Okay.
Well,
here's your placings. Race 17, Chris's Rock 5, Yobro Dante 4, Cherokee's Promise did not finish, GV Brandenbrook was the winner, GV Don't Miss a Beat 2, Jandai Candy Time 3. From the top down, 5-4, DNF 1-2-3. Fractional times for the 17th, the quarter was trotted in 38 seconds. Time of the win, 1:15. Time of the second horse, 1:16-1. Time of the third horse, 1:16-4. Upcoming race 18, Field of 7, Fast Pacers.
All right, here we go.
Drivers, y'all out.
Yep, and they should be parading them from the grandstand. I said, we have a pretty good crowd. You see, here, see? Pretty good crowd tonight. They're all social distancing. They're doing the right thing tonight.
Pacers are on the track here for tonight's 18th. Our nightcap finale featured event. 106 and faster. Free-for-all Pacers. There are no changes. The one is Silver Tux, owned by Bruce Wyman, Luke Miller Drives. 2 GV Golden Joy, owned by the Triple E Stables with Jeremy Chupp. 3 is Sir Cool, owned by the Rocky Ridge Stables, Jason Yoder Drives. 4 is Sassy Cass, owned by Pedigree Point Racing with Virgil Slaybaugh. 5, Hilltop Victor, owner-driver Rose Bontrager. The 6, Cherokee's Iron Man, owned by Arnold and Robin Manders, Dale Miller Drives. And the 7, MI's Where's the Party, owned by Eddie Rogue of Bermuda, David Miller is in the sulky. 7, Fast Free-for-All Pacers will be at the gate in 1 minute.
And when he says fast, yeah, they're fast. They are quick.
Okay. Once again, just a reminder, we need the committee here after this race, immediately following this race, for a review. Need the committee, review committee, here after race 18. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we hope you've enjoyed the racing here this evening. We've got 18 more heats of exciting action-packed racing scheduled tomorrow night. First post, 6 p.m. Hope to see you here. Oops. Also, we would like to see you here next weekend. Next Friday and Saturday night, we're right back here. Next weekend is JCO weekend. We welcome all JCO employees and their families. Also have the 3/4 mile race for Trotters and Pacers next Saturday night right here at LaGrange. Well, the starting gate is rolling. It's post time, race 18.
All right, here we go. I said, folks, This is gonna go quick.
4 on the gate, 3 trailers. Starting gate has entered the stretch in. Here they come. And they're off in, pacing Sir Cool from the inside. Silver Tux, GV Gold, and Joy from in between horses. 3 wide into that first turn. Hilltop Victor's in the mix. In between horses, Cherokee's Iron Man, MI's Where's the Party. 3 wide, Sassy Cast to the inside. Oh, bunched up. 3 by 2 by 2. As they head around that far turn, 3 wide, Sir Cool with a nose in front from the grandstand side. GV Gold and Joy and Silver Tux won't give an inch as they reach the quarter mile marker. Opening quarter, 33 seconds. Silver Cool, or Silver Tux rather. GB Gold and Joy, and to the outside, still parked, 3 wide is Sir Cool, and to the outside with that live outer flow comes GB Gold and Joy. Out of the far turn they come, from the set of the packets, GB Gold and Joy poking a nose in front. Silver Tux has seen enough, and Sir Cool to the outside is retreating as they head for home. It's GB Gold and Joy, an impressive showing tonight.
All right, they have race 18. I said, folks, I told you it was going to be quick, and sure enough, it was. So, oh, I had Francis listening from Bermuda 2 weeks ago. Oh, we had somebody from Bermuda. Okay. I didn't know that. Thanks, Judy. I didn't realize that. So again, if you go to the ITPA website on Wednesday, you will find all the results from tonight. And then you'll find the lineup also there Wednesday for next Friday and Saturday races here at Napanee at LaGrange. Sorry, I didn't mean that. All right.
Heading trackside, winning tonight's finale, the 2 GV Golden Joy, 6-year-old mare. Sired by Soaring Gold, out of the mare GV Larry's Amy. Owned by the Triple E Stables, trained by the Triple C Racing Stables, Jeremy Chupp is your winning driver. 6th win on 8 starts for the 2020 campaign for GV Golden Joy as she paced the quarter mile at 105 2/5. See you, Brucer. Come here tomorrow. Okay. One moment for your placings.
Is it aged or fourth? We got this. This is for third. All right, hold it. Whoever that is in the middle. Can anybody tell?
All right.
Okay, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on.
All right, hang on.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
You've got, just a minute here. Is right here in the green bike.
Okay. No, no.
I know. You need that one?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought that was.
That's the winner.
No, no, no. They've went through. This is third.
Oh, my bad.
This
okay.
is third. Whoever it might be.
Back it up to where we have the first.
Well, I think we've got to go in real time here to see.
All
right. So just.
He'll be third. The green bike will be fifth.
Green bike will be fifth. All right, I got that down.
It's going to go full speed.
We're going to go full speed and see if we can.
Oh, you're so close on everything.
Oh. Okay, that was Luke. No. Yeah. Yeah, Luke. Because that was second place horse right there.
Yeah.
That's second place. That's Silver Tux. That's the one.
Yeah, he was second. Now here we are.
Yeah, right here.
All right, this guy, whoever this guy is, was third.
Third, and then Dale, he was fourth.
This guy had to be fourth.
No, second, third, fourth is what I'm saying.
Oh.
Am I right?
This is. That's they was that close to
yeah,
him?
Yeah.
Oh,
second,
okay.
Third.
Whoever this is.
Well, and that's what we got to figure out. I know these two.
This is Dale.
Dale is fourth.
Dale's fourth.
And that's Jason Yoder. The three was fifth.
Yeah. Let it go to here.
Forward
it. This one, this guy has to be whoever's left.
You want me to go back?
No, forward.
Forward.
Forward
a little bit.
Forward.
Just a little.
That's okay. That's green color, so that's Dave. Dave Miller. So the seven was sixth.
One more.
And that's Virgil.
Virgil. And
Virgil.
Was that other horse?
Okay, so seven. Okay, so one, two. Sassy Hilltop Victor was third. Rose was third.
Okay, is that who that was?
215-7346.
Yep. Okay.
215.
Exhausting.
Are you on the review committee?
Here's your placings, ladies and gentlemen, for race 18, Silver Tux 2. GV Golden Joy the winner, Sir Cool 5, Sassy Cass 7, Hilltop Victor 3, Cherokee's Iron Man 4, MI's Where's the Party 6. From the top down, 215-7346. Fractional times, the quarter was paced in 33 seconds. Time of the win, 105.25. Time of the second horse was 106. Time of the third horse, 106.35. Thanks again, ladies and gentlemen, for coming out tonight. Hoping to see you tomorrow night. First post, 6 p.m. Also, ladies and gentlemen, make sure, horsemen, rather, you see Lisa Lowe if you need Indiana Breeders' Sale consignment forms. Those are due a week from tomorrow night to Lisa. Thanks again. Have a great night. Have a safe trip home.
All right, folks, we'll see you tomorrow night right back here at LaGrange. Post time 6 o'clock, 5:50 airtime from here at LaGrange. Until tomorrow, good evening from LaGrange County 4-H Fairgrounds.